The ayat recited by my beloved son and brother, the end of Surah Al-An'am. And Surah Al-An'am is having a different characteristics from other surahs in the Quran. It is the surah that guides to at-tawheed in details. And I think Sayyid Qutb in his Dhilal Quran has done. I don't think that he did everything of his effort, as much as I think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was opening his heart when he was writing the meanings of Quran in jail. Because he felt what dunya is. And he felt that he has nobody. He is lonely. But the only company and companion he could have is Allah. And this is how he wrote the meanings of Surah Al-An'am. قُلْ إِنَّنِي هَدَانِي رَبِّي إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. This Sirat Mustaqim is Deenan, Qiyaman, Millata Ibrahim Hanifan. Ibrahim is given a model. Why? Because he sacrificed everything, the most beloved thing, to please Allah. He is the model of what we call tajarrud. Gives up everything. Can you imagine when a person has a child who is born after waiting and the father is aging more than 70 or 80. He has that child. And when the child is 8, 9, 10, the story of Ya Bunayya Inni Ara Fil Manami Anni Adbahuk. He takes his son to slaughter him without any hesitation. And the son was as responsive as his father. This is Millata Ibrahim. Millah means a style of life, way of life. And Ibrahim was distinctive, a unique person in what? In cleansing everything of his entity and everything of what he dealt with from shirk. The only thing in his entity and in his life is Allah. Hanifan. Clean and cleanse. ملة إبراهيم حنيفا مسلما وما كان من المشركين. Then قل إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين. My life, everything of my life, as well as my death, my end, belongs to Allah. قل إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين لا شريك له وبذلك أمرت وأنا أول المسلمين. It means that you should compete for accomplishing everything of those items. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر.